It was, there was another billionaire in town, and Kurt was not yet a billionaire. He was a, he was a 100 billionaire, but it was all at risk. And the other guy was named Howard Hughes. And Howard Hughes, Kurt thought was one of his friends, so that they had some similar interests as aviators and movie owners and rich men. But Howard was secretly working against Kurt Hughes, too. Howard decided, Howard said, told his people, Las Vegas isn't big enough for two of us. Kirk had the opposite. He felt like the best thing that could happen in Las Vegas was for everybody to compete. Again, here's this competitive boxer, tennis player, and businessman.
It also seemed like, you mentioned the Armenian earthquake in 1988, it seemed like that was a catalyst, at least in the book, for setting the stage for a lot of his philanthropy in the latter parts of his life. How did he view philanthropy, and how did that change over time? Because there were some shifts there.
Well, yeah. Kirk prior to the earthquake, Kirk was an extremely generous philanthropist. But you didn't know it because he was, I don't know, some got to be some people here old enough to remember a TV show called The Millionaire. But it was a TV show where every week the secret millionaire gave $1 million to somebody on the condition that they never explain where the money came from, never credit the giver. Kirk was like that. He gave generously everywhere, and but with the caveat, you can't tell anybody I gave this to you. Otherwise, you'll never get another dime. So even after the earthquake, before the airlift began, Kirk gave money to Armenian causes, to Armenian groups that were helping with the earthquake recovery. But it was with the same caveat, don't tell anybody. But then he took some heat in the media for not stepping up and helping. That's when he formed the Lindsay Foundation. I think he really